Hi friends, welcome back to CADable. This is Engineer Brian Umar, and in this tutorial we'll learn how to use limit distance mate in Solidworks assembly. And here you can see that I have used a width mate, a concentric mate and a limit distance mate. Okay, so let's select all these, right click, and I will select this one, delete. Yes to all. Okay, now I will apply these mates one by one. So first of all, I'll go to here assembly, and I'll go to here mate, and here I'll go to here advanced mate, and I will select this one, width mate. So in width mate we have two types of selection. First is width selection and then tab selection. So in width selection I will pick this face and I will pick this back face, and in the tab selection I will pick this face and I will pick this back face. Okay, now you can see that my object is centered right in this plane. Okay, and I will select this one, okay. Next is we will use a simple concentric mate. So let's go to your mate again, and this time I will select this one, concentric, and I will pick this face and I will pick this face. And now you can see that my object is inverted, so I will pick this one, flip mate alignment, and I will select okay. Now you can see that my part basically will translate in this channel, okay, but you can see that it is creating an interference with this object and with this object. So here I have to apply a limit distance mate. Okay, here I will discuss a very important thing, and that is the difference between distance mate and a limit distance mate. Basically this mate, distance mate, is a static mate. Okay, if you apply, let's say, a distance mate, let's go to here distance mate, and first I will select this face and I will select this face. And let's say I will apply a distance of, let's say, 50. Okay, so distance mate is a static mate. Okay, you cannot move your object. Basically it creates a stationary mate. And limit distance mate is a dynamic mate, where you can move your object up to a certain extent. So I will delete this mate, distance mate. Now we will apply a limit distance mate here. So let's say this distance is 190. Between this face and this face. Let's go to here major. I will select this face and I will select this face, and here you can see that the distance is 190. So let's go to here mate, and let's go to here advanced mate, and here you will find this option, limit distance mate. So first I will select this face and I will select this face. Okay, sorry, this face, not this edge. Okay, and here I will write 0, and here I will write 190. Okay, and I will select okay, and now this distance mate, this limit distance mate will work. And here you can see that it is not working correctly. This distance would be let's say 150, not 190, and here I am using this face and this face as a reference, not this face. Okay, so this distance would be 150. Okay, let's check it out. Let's go to here evaluate major, select this face and this face, and here you can see that this distance is 150. Okay, so let's edit this mate. Let's go to your limit distance, edit feature, and here I will use 150 instead of 190. And select OK. And now this limit distance mate will work correctly. Checked OK. And now you can see that this limit distance mate is working correctly. So that's how you can use width mate, distance mate, limit distance mate, and concentric mate in SolidWorks assembly. I hope you like this short tutorial. And if you have any questions, any query related to this tutorial or any other tutorial in my list, you can ask in comment section. Thanks for watching. And please subscribe to our channel for more informative and interesting projects. Thank you.